हेलो एवरीवन एंड गुड मॉर्निंग एंड लेट्स बिगिन. आई लाइक टू टेल यू दैट देर इज अ सडन और चेंज अ लिटिल चेंज इन टाइम टेबल. मे बी आई थिंक इट वॉज मैथमेटिक्स लेक्चर बट ड्यू टू सम रीजन्स ही इज नॉट एबल टू कंडक्ट हिज क्लास. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट professional communication will be there. So all you people couldn't take note of it, that this class will be of professional communication. So if you have notebook, you just bring it out and let's begin what we people started with. We are going to continue in this class. Okay, so let's begin. I will share the screen. Just wait for 1 minute. Okay, so now somebody just reply me, is my voice audible to everyone and is the screen also visible? If it is visible, say yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Thank you. So if you remember in previous class, we people have talked about professional communication and what you people are expected to do after completion of your graduation, and you people will be looking for jobs and you people may be looking for interviews and group discussion and all those things. I think that we people have discussed all those points. So now we people are going to talk about that syllabus, and in syllabus, I think we people have already talked about this, that unit number one, presentation skills. So in presentation skills, you people are expected to give presentations on number of occasions. Maybe it might be your company's project, or you may be working on some schemes, or maybe at some other occasions, you people are expected to just give presentations. So presentation skills are important part of your professional life. So you people are expected to work on it. If you are not good at presentation, giving presentations, so you people will work on this. So let's try to understand what these presentation skills will be. So you people are expected to prepare short presentations and deliver it. And for that purpose, presentation skills are part of oral communication. So oral communication is spoken, that in the form of speaking. So therefore, you should improve your pronunciation, intonation, stress, and rhythm. All those are the aspects of the spoken communication, or therefore we people will try to work on it, and we people will improve our pronunciation, intonation, stress, and rhythm. How to improve pronunciation, what is intonation, stress, which stress you are considering, all those points we people will talk when we people will start actually learning all those things. Then next, I think 1.2 also we people discussed that presentation. When you people are thinking of presentation, many of you might have completed MSAT course, or many of you might have completed your CCC course. So in that, perhaps you might have used a PowerPoint presentation. So in that, you people are expected to prepare PPTs based on your knowledge. You need to collect data for that, information for that, and then you people have to organize these data, and you people have to make slides, and there should be a flow, logical sequence, and then at the end, you people have to check everything is fine, and at the end, you people are going to give presentation, oral presentation, maybe in front of your batch or in front of your class. So what effective planning is required here, and how you will prepare and how you deliver it. All those points we people will learn in this 1.2. So that is all about unit number one. Then next we people will talk about unit number two, and unit number two is group discussion. As we people have already talked about recruitment process. So any of the company which is going to select students, and for that there is a recruitment process. So in this recruitment process, you people are expected to go through these things. So after completing of your first round, that is of aptitude, you people will be called for group discussions. But here I would like to tell that not all companies conduct group discussions, but there may be chances that majority of the companies, they conduct a group discussion. There may be one or another company, they may not conduct a group discussion, but you people have to prepare for group discussion also. So in this group discussion, we people will be looking for what is group discussion first of all, then traits here. Traits means which are the characteristics evaluated during group discussion, what kind of evaluation these people do. So first of all, your communication skills, then they will look for your behavior, your nature, your attitude, your language, and your cooperation. Or they will also look for what kind of team skills you people have, leadership skills you people have. So therefore, all those aspects we people have to consider. It is not only communication, and other aspects also we people have to think of. Then types of group discussion we people will talk about. Then tips for successful participation. Very important is this, that if we have understood what is group discussion, and if we understood what traits are evaluated, but if you are not going to follow any tips or certain tips, it will be difficult for you to sustain in group discussion or qualify group discussion round. So to qualify group discussion round, you people will get some tips here, and if you follow these tips, they will help you to perform effectively in group discussion. And at the end, there is individual traits also that are important that we people will like to discuss here in this unit number two. Okay, so after discussing this group discussion, we people will go for unit number three. And in unit number three, there is personal interview. Okay, so again, this is very important. Don't consider this is part of your study. It is not part of your study. In fact, it is part of your professional life, because on number of occasions you people are going to face interviews, and you people are expected to prepare well for it. It is not only for first time. It is not only for after completion of your third year or after completion of your graduation. Maybe at other occasions also, you people are expected to face interviews, because you want to switch your job. Once you got selected into one company, you're not going to spend your entire life in that company. At other times, you're going to switch that company, you're going to resign in that company, and you're going to join another company. Okay, so there also you people are expected to give interviews. So interview is part of your professional life, and at number of times you people are expected to give your interviews. But at that time, you might be experienced, but right now you people are freshers, and as a fresher, you may be feeling it challenging that how to crack interview. So therefore, let's try to understand what personal interview and how to prepare for it. So in this unit, we people will first of all talk about introduction of personal interview. So what is personal interview, and why is it conducted, and types of interview, panel interview, face-to-face interview, some preparatory steps for employment interviews. So as I told you, you people are going to face employment interviews. So if you follow some steps that you people will be benefited by it, it will be useful for you. Some skill tips so that you people can improve on the basis of maybe as a practice, you people will feel confident if you follow those tips. And then next will be frequently asked questions during interview. So we'll practice mock interviews also. So you people will be given a list of questions like introduce yourself. Then why do you want to work with us? What are your strengths? What are your weaknesses? So such kind of questions will be given to you. You people are expected to prepare for such questions. And then we people will conduct mock interviews also. So that will be your unit number three, personal interview. Okay, so is it audible? Still visible? Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right, good. then we people will go for the next slide, and on next slide you people will think of unit number 4 is there, and unit number 4 is writing practices second. Okay, so why it is writing practices second, who will tell me why it is second not first? Because writing practices first that we people have completed in semester 1, there we people have discussed about writing business letters, so inquiry letter, order letter, complaint letter, email communication, paragraph writing, essay writing, so that was also part of writing practices, and that was writing practices first which we people have completed in semester first. Okay, so don't even just neglect or forget about this also, because that is going to help you. So whenever we people get free time, you people try to revise format of letter writing, or some of the information you people try to collect about email writing, paragraph writing, essay writing, or rather than every day you just write one paragraph, that is going to help you. Okay, so now in semester second in professional communication, we people are going to have this unit writing practices second, and in this writing practices second you people are going to have this 4.1 resume writing. So in previous slide we people have talked about personal interview. If you are going to appear for interview, you are not allowed to appear for interview if you are not having resume with you. So what is this resume? I already talked about that people are going to get concepts like maybe biodata sometimes, or you people may be getting this term resume, or there is another term I would like to say, that is CV. So these three terms are maybe similar, but they are not exact same. There is a difference. There is a lot of difference in fact. So what is biodata? Biodata is nothing but your only personal information, that your name, your address, your maybe contact details, and your date of birth, and everything. Your personal information will be there. So this is basic form. Then resume will be a broader concept than biodata. So here you people are going to add all your details, that your career objective will come here, then your educational qualifications, that maybe your BTech is there, your HSC is there, SSC is there, and that academic details will be there, your trainings, your maybe any project you people have done, all this information you people are going to include in your resume. And afterwards you people are going to add some technical skills, some soft skills, your strengths and weaknesses maybe you are going to add. And then resume, it is a broader term. So if you are going to prepare your CV, it means that you have experience of minimum 8 years, 10 years you have experience, and with that experience you are just maybe holding a lot of responsible posts, and you have successfully completed some of the responsibilities, that time it will be CV. So first it is biodata, then it is resume, and then it is CV. So right now you people are expecting, you people have to write your resumes, and you people have to present your resumes. See, resume is the, I think that reflection of your personality. So what you are, it will be understood by your resume, because before you, your resume reaches to the recruiter. And when they just go through your resume, they'll come to know that how are you academically, what are your hobbies, and all those things they will come to know if they go through your resumes. So your resume should be powerful or effective, so that it creates a positive impression for our interview. So all you people think that how you people can prepare resumes well. So here we people will talk about this. Then next 4.2 is here. So in 4.2 we people are going to talk about report writing. So this is also part of your professional life. So once you started working with companies, organizations, so that time you people are expected to prepare reports. So various kinds of reports are there. So out of that, technical report writing we people will talk about here, then types, then structure of report, then data collection. So writing report, it is not like that you are writing a paragraph. Paragraph writing is a different thing, and report writing is a different thing. So you need to collect the data for writing a report, and that data can be collected from various sources. Sources can be primary sources or secondary sources also. Then you'll think of the content. and form. So whatever the data you have collected, you have to organize this data and you have to put it in proper format. Okay, so this way we people will try to write down reports also. And then next one is this here, that is precise writing. So what is this precise writing? Precise writing is nothing but it is a summary writing. I think that maybe you people have experienced it in 10th standard or 12th standard English, that there was some question based on summary writing. So you people were given one paragraph and you people have to convert that paragraph into 1/3 summary. So similar here, you people have to just point out main ideas out of these given details. Only the important facts you people have to cover here and you people have to summarize it in short. So this is precise writing. So what should be included and what should not be included, that we people will talk in detail when we people will learn precise writing in our following lectures. So that was all about unit number 4, writing practices second. Then we people will go to the next slide, and on next slide you people will see unit number 5 is there. And unit number 5 is induction to soft skills. See, it is induction, it is not introduction. So don't get confused here, that you may just think that this is introduction to soft skill, but it is not introduction to the soft skill, but it is induction to soft skills. So what is induction? Induction is nothing but you are going to get acquainted, you are going to get familiar with all those skills. So therefore this is induction. So first of all, we people will talk about this 5.1, and in 5.1 you people are going to have your own SWOC analysis. So who will tell me what is this SWOC analysis? Can anybody reply? Tell me what is this SWOC analysis. Or you do not have any idea what is this SWOC? Reply me, tell me. Rohan, I am not audible what you said. If you have said anything, I could not listen you.
Don't know, sir, about that.
Okay, all right. So this is new to you, so I think that this is our own analysis based on your strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and let's say challenges. So S stands for what? Strengths. So all of us, we people have strengths. So what are strengths? What we will consider strengths? So suppose that I am good in a particular skill, maybe any skill it may be. So it can be honesty, hardworking, sincere, punctual. So this can be my strength. So you people have to analyze, you people have to think of your own personality, and you people have to think that in which things you people are good, and that can be your strength. So you people have to find out your strengths. Then next we people will talk about W. So now W stands for your weaknesses. Yes, you're right. So weaknesses means what? So I think that no one is perfect. No one is perfect. I'm not perfect. Or to whom you meet, or you consider that they are great and they are successful and they are like this and that. Nobody is perfect in this world. So everyone, in fact, they have some kind of weaknesses. So we people need to find some weaknesses of us. So perhaps I think that nobody will accept this, I have some weakness, but it is there. We need to find out. Or there is no any kind of hesitation to consider that your weaknesses. Suppose that my weakness is that I'm introvert. Introvert means what? I'm not speak much, or if I have to speak with new people, I cannot start, or I do not mix easily, or in short time I cannot mix with new people, or I hesitate to speak with new people. So that can be a weakness. So you people have to find out your weaknesses, something like this, that you people are taking time for learning, or you people are just emotional or sentimental, or you cannot say no to help anyone, or if anybody is asking you for help, you cannot say no, or you take a lot of responsibility on your own. So, or maybe you pay little attention to your health, something like this. So those can be your weaknesses. So here you people are expected to find out your own weaknesses. And because this is part of your interview, in interview, this question is asked, what are your strengths? What are your weaknesses? So accordingly, you people are expected to prepare for strengths and weaknesses. Okay, then we people will talk about what is O. So O is, O stands for opportunities. Yes. So opportunities based on your strength and weaknesses analysis, what opportunities are for you? So people have to find out, suppose that if you are honest or if you are hardworking, if you are focused, you can say opportunities for me that I can complete any task or the given task, I do not left incomplete. So whatever you start, you finish it. And so you think that opportunities for you are, you people can grow, you can become or you can climb higher posts immediately or in short span. You can get promotions and you can become manager or you can go to higher posts because of your strengths are supporting to you. So therefore, you people are getting some opportunities based on your strengths and weaknesses. And then we people will talk about C. So C stands for challenges. So in fact, it was earlier SWOT and T was threats. But instead of threats, we people talk about challenges. So challenges means something that you think or you for you it is difficult. It is not impossible. It is not maybe your need to apply all your energy, all your skills and everything, and you people have to face it. So that is going to become your challenges. So all you people are expected to just do your own analysis of this SWOC and try to note it down and just work on these things. If your strengths you identify, you try to make it more stronger. If you could find your weaknesses, you people have to work on it and try to eliminate or reduce those weaknesses. And just again work on your opportunities and try to grab those opportunities and achieve your goals. Pradeep, is there any problem? Is my voice audible?
Yes.
And then think about the challenges and try to meet such challenges and overcome those challenges. And achieve your goals. So for achieving success in your life, in personal life as well as in your professional life, the people are expected to go through this ESW analysis. I think that your Zoom has not the 1 hour span. In 40 minutes it gets disconnected. Am I right?
Yes.
So what we people will do? We people will confirm our attendance. And then you people will stop. So for today's class, absent numbers are roll number 13, 16, 26, 30, then 46, 48, 52, 53, 56, 59, 60, 64, 66, 67, and 68. If anybody is present, just tell me you're present.
Sir, 13.
13 is present. Okay, who is next?
48
is also present. Okay, anyone? Okay, all right. Once again, confirm option numbers 16, 26, 30, then 46, 52, 53, 56, 59, 60, 64, 66, 67, and 68. Okay, all right. So we are not going to join back. We are going to continue for this only. So what your time maybe after 10 minutes if you get disconnected, we will not join back.
49 sir present.
49, yes, your 49 is present. I have not taken your role number in absent numbers.
Yes sir.
Okay, all right. Now pay attention. So in 5.1, we people will talk about this personal analysis. and we people have to do it. And it is part of your personality. Remember, this is not only part of study. This is not only part of this second semester professional communication. Don't limit this topic for only particular this semester only, or for this for PC only. It is going to part of your life, professional life, or in personal life also. Then we people will talk about goal settings. So what is goal setting? You people try to tell me in short. What is it? What do you understand by this goal setting?
What we want to achieve.
Yes, something that you want to achieve in your life. Because see, if you are living your life without any goal, how it will be? It will be like, let's say, a vehicle without driver or without direction. So you are having a car, but you don't know where to go, or the car is moving, but it don't know the ways or where to reach, where to go. So something like this. Or you people can take example of a log of wood. A log of wood which is floating in the river or in the ocean, it has no directions. So therefore, it is just moving in the direction where wind takes to it. So our life can be same. If you are not having goal in your life, your life can be wandering here and there. You can be just maybe spending your time aimlessly. So you should have a goal in your life. So try to define your goals. So try to finalize your goals. If you have not finalized it right now, today you just take a time, maybe 1 hour or 2 hours, and set your goals for your life. And once you got your goals, you people can work on those goals. See, goals can be again two types. So these goals can be short-term goals and long-term goals. What is in short-term goals? That the things that you wanted to achieve in short span of time, maybe at the end of 1 month, at the end of 6 months, at the end of 1 year. Pradeep Dumar, what happens with you? Roll number 20. Is there any problem? Pradeep? Is it audible, Pradeep?
Yes, sir.
Is there any difficulty for you for understanding or voice or anything?
No, sir. There are touch sensitivity kharab zale mhanun te mic open hote ka.
Okay, so take care. Fine. So short-term goals are something that you want to just complete in short span of time. Okay, up to 1 year maximum. So you just try to define that how you wanted to complete your all these subjects and what you want to do in maybe next 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. About you set your goals about your ISCs, you set your goals about your unit tests, you set goals about maybe this semester also, how much percentage you want to go. So all those goals will be short-term goals. So let's talk about now long-term goals. So what you can think of long-term goals? Long-term goals can be a longer period of time. So you wanted to get selected into multinational companies. You wanted to complete your graduation. You wanted to start your own business. You wanted to just improve your English communication. So all these will come into long-term goals. So goal setting is important, and you have to set your goals. You just write it down, such short-term goals and long-term goals. And those paper you can stick in front of your, maybe you can stick it in the notebooks, all subject notebooks. You write down your short-term goals, long-term goals. You can stick those short-term goals and long-term goals in your room also, where every day you, those goals will be in front of your eyes. Otherwise, simply you will be again aimless, or you will not remember your goals. Why I'm asking you people to write down it in your notebooks? Because always they will remind you that you people have to do some work. You have to hard work, you have to maybe just keep working, keep studying. Those goals will help you to remember your always, that it is not simple. And you maybe suppose that at one point you think that you are spending, wasting your time. Immediately your goals will remind you that immediately you have to stop all those things and you have to work towards your goal. So for this, suppose that just take an example that you are in Pandharpur and you wanted to go to Solapur. So Solapur is your destination, Solapur is your goal, and your journey can start. Your journey can be one step at a time, but it started towards your goal that you will start walking towards the Solapur. But see, if you don't know where to go, your journey will be no journey, because it may be in opposite direction also, or it may be at other ways also. And you are not going to reach towards the Solapur, maybe in spite of a number of days you're walking, but you are not going to reach to Solapur. But you know that you wanted to reach to Solapur, maybe you may take time, but one day you are going to reach to Solapur. Okay, so therefore it is important that you should have goals to your life. So you decide your goals and just keep them in front of you. It should be always in front of your eyes. You should not forget your goals. See, if you forget your goals, you are going to go away from your goals. So don't forget about your goals. So next week people will talk about motivation. So 5.3, it is about your motivation. So do you think anything can be done without motivation, or is it possible to become successful in your life without motivation?
No,
it is not possible. So you people just tell me the sources of motivation, because of what you get motivated in your life. You people reply me.
Other successful persons.
Yes, success of other people, you get motivated. Other people try to answer me. What motivates you?
Motivational speech.
Yes, motivational speeches, they motivate you. Yes, you are right. Any other things? Or can't you think of any other things? It can be movies also. If you watch a movie, don't you get inspired? Don't you get motivated? It can be movies also. You can watch movies and you can be motivated. It can be books also. If you read a book, do you feel motivated? Yes, you feel motivated if you read a book. Maybe there are some motivational books like, have you read You Can Win by Shiv Khera? Or maybe in Marathi, Yash Tumcha Hatat. If not, all you people
can. Yes, sir.
Okay, Sanskriti. If you have not gone through this, I will recommend here for all you people. There are so many books which can be life-changing books, but I will recommend here. You people have to go through this book. You Can Win. This is by Shiv Khera. This is the name of author. In Marathi, it is also available. In Marathi, Yash Tumcha Hatat. So try to get this book from anywhere. Maybe from library, like in library it is available, but when you people will come to college, you can just get this book. If not, you can buy it. Maybe 100 to 100 rupees will be there, but I'm sure that this book will change your life. You will get motivated all the time. You will come to know how things may happen if you are motivated, and if you are not motivated, what is happens with you. Okay, so all you people I'm sure that people will try to get this book and you will read it. So motivation is important. I think that this is last minute. You people are going to get disconnected at any moment. So you people are going to join next class. We are going to stop here. Okay. So motivation is important. Remaining part that books and some assignments that you people will discuss in next class. So if you are motivated, you people will achieve great things in your life. And you people can face challenges. You people will think that what